Class 10, as we have already started with the chapter, The Making of a Scientist. Okay, so let us revise about it, what this chapter is about. The chapter is about Robert E. Bright. And what was his greatest accomplishment? That he has, at the age of 22, along with his college friends, he has made an invention which explains that how DNA it replicates, and ultimately his article was published in the which journal? It was Proceedings, National Proceedings of, yes, tell me. On the very first, in the very first paragraph. Yes, Proceedings of the National Academy of Science, right? So remember this name of the journal, that it was for the first time it was published, that otherwise, this journal is not at all publishing the articles of the students, but it is for the first time that the article of the student is published in this journal. So, what was his interest? His interest was collecting butterflies. But apart from it, what he was also collecting? He was also collecting fossils, coins, okay, fossils and coins, and some rocks also. And when he was in grade 2 to 3, he has collected almost all the 25 species of butterflies that were available in his hometown. And moreover, who was his great companion, or who is responsible for helping him? His mother. So what is the role of the mother played in making of a scientist? She is bringing all the scientific material for him, including microscopes, telescopes, mounting material, slides, and everything else. And moreover, she has never left everything upon him only, but what he has to, she always has to be a good companion of him. They used to spend time together in the dining room in the evening doing some work. And moreover, his mother tells that when she did not have any work, what her mother is doing, her mother used to bring some work for him. And what kind of work? Some learning work, but not any kind of physical work. So this is the role of the woman played in making of this scientist. So next, afterwards, when he was in grade 7, he has participated in the science fair. But what happened? He did not win a prize. So what he has shown? Why he did not win a prize there? Because the other students have shown the live experiments. And what he has shown? He has shown the slides of frog tissue. So what lesson he has learned from there? Yes, then he has to, it means that it is not only showing a neat display will help him to win a prize. For winning a prize, what he has to do? He has to do some real experiments. Then afterwards, to whom his mother has written a letter? To Professor Urquhart, okay? And ultimately, many ideas they have come to him. Okay, and out of it, then what experiment he has conducted after that in class grade 8? What experiment he has conducted, that he has studied that why the monarch caterpillars, they are being killed. Okay, they are being killed, they are being dead. And ultimately, they consider beetles as the responsible ones for this. So what they have done, he has raised some beetles among those caterpillars, but ultimately, although he was not able to get any results, but what is there? He has still won a prize, okay? Okay, right. So finally, I'm reading from page number 35. The last point which I have spoken, in order to relate it, I'm reading this paragraph for the 8th grade. For the 8th grade project, E. Bright tried to find the cause of a viral disease that kills nearly all monarch caterpillars every few years. And E. Bright thought the disease might be carried by a beetle. So what he did, that he has collected the caterpillars and he has raised them among the beetles, because he thought that it is because of beetles that this disease is spreading. So I didn't get any real results, he said. But what he said that he did not get any real results. And I went ahead and showed that I had tried the experiment and this time I won. So it means that he has represented his experiment as it is a new idea in this field. So he has won a prize for this. So what he has learned, he has also come to know that he prime is also... Yes? No, it will be mentioned further. Okay, when other experiments will be done, it will be mentioned there. So, the next year, his science fair project was testing the theory that viceroy butterflies copy monarchs. So, next year, what he has in the science fair project, what experiment he has done, that these viceroy butterflies, they copy monarchs. They used to copy monarch caterpillars or butterflies, but why? The theory was that viceroys look like monarchs because monarchs don't taste good to birds. So it means that sometimes these are the changes the insects or the living beings they bring about in their behavior. Why? You please keep quiet. Kindly be quiet. So, why these viceroy butterflies, they are copying the monarchs? It is because of the reason that monarch butterflies, when birds they eat, they don't taste good to them. So, if viceroys, they will change their outlook and they will look like that of monarchs, even birds won't eat them. But monarch viceroys, they are tasty for birds. So, to avoid it, they were changing their appearance. And viceroys, on the other hand, do taste good to birds. So the more they look like monarchs, the less likely they are to become a bird's dinner. So ultimately, why these viceroy butterflies, they are copying the monarchs? Because monarch butterflies, they are not at all, you can say, tasting good to the birds. Because birds eat those caterpillars, butterflies, and birds don't like monarchs. So viceroys, which are, you can say, favorite of birds, they are changing themselves like that of monarchs. Why? So that the birds will not eat them. Okay? In order to survive. Right. So, E. Bright's project was to see whether, in fact, birds would eat monarchs. He found that a startling would not eat ordinary bird food. It would eat all the monarchs it could get. So, what was Ebright's project? That he wanted to find whether the birds would eat those monarchs or not. So, when he has conducted this experiment, he has, you can say, done his experiment. What he has come to know? He has come to know that the birds, they don't eat, whether they eat monarchs or not. So, finally, he has come out with this conclusion that the birds will eat all the monarchs that come into their way. E. Bright said later research by other people showed that viceroys probably do copy the monarchs. So later on, when other people, they have made the research, they have come to know, yes, of course, that viceroy butterflies, they were of course copying the monarchs. Now you come to know why viceroys, they were copying the monarch butterflies. Is it clear? Yes, right, in order to survive so that they could not be the bird's favorite dinner. This project was placed in the zoology division and third overall in the county science fair. So in the county science fair, he has won overall third position, but in zoology section, it was first. So it means he was learning day by day. Okay, as he was learning day by day, he was coming to know that what actually science is and what kind of experiments he has to conduct in order to win different kind of prizes. Right? So like for the first time, he was not able to win any prize. And later on after that, what has happened? He was winning the prize. Okay, he was winning the prize. Okay, why? Because he has come to know that he must take something different, some different subject, okay, for his experimentation. And later on when he has come to know, he has done the experiments on the, you can say, unusual topics. When he was doing the experiments on the unusual topics, so this helped him to bag different prizes. So every year when he is participating in the science fair, so every time he is getting one or the other prize, right? So, in the second year to in high school, Richard E. Bright began the research that led to his discovery of an unknown insect hormone, and indirectly it also led to his new theory on the life of cells. So when he was in the second year of his high school, E. Bright, he has started his research, which led to the discovery of what? It led to the discovery of an unknown fact about the life of cells. Okay, what he has come to know, that he was studying an insect hormone when he was in his high school, and while studying that insect hormone, means in foreign countries there must be something different. High school, maybe it will maybe extended after plus two, right? So this is the reason, okay, why they are mentioning in this way. Okay, so while they're studying, it means that he was not in at the age of 17 or 18 when he has done. He was at the age of 22. It means it must be after plus one and plus two that he has done that. Okay, when he was in the second year of his high school, what he was studying, he was conducting his research upon an insect hormone. And there what happened? Then he has come to his unusual theory on the life of cells. So how this happens? This we are going to read further. The question he tried to answer was simple. What is the purpose of the 12 tiny gold spots on a menage pupa? So what was the reason of his study of insect hormone? So what point he has taken into consideration? He was studying the menage pupa. And on the menage pupa, on the wings of menage pupa, there were 12 golden spots. He wanted to find out the function or find out the reason that why these gold spots exist. What is the function? What is the motive? Are they only ornamental to attract the insects, or some special, you can say some kind of special, you can say function it performs. So this he wanted to study. And for that, he was studying menage pupas. So he was studying those gold spots that were present on the wings of the caterpillar of menage, that were present upon the menage pupa, on the wings of menage pupa. Everyone assumes that the spots were just ornamental. But E. Bright said, but Professor Urquhart didn't believe it. So what everybody was having the belief that these spots are only ornamental, showy in nature. They don't serve any specific purpose. But Professor, whom he was following, he was not at all believing it. And even E. Bright thought that these are ornamental. But later on, he carried forward his research in this direction only. To find the answer, E. Bright, another excellent science student, first had to build a device that showed that spots were producing a hormone necessary for the butterfly's full development. Yes. See, in order to find the answer to this question, so what he did, E. Bright, along with another science student who was also good in studies and who was also having good research skills, they have formulated a device which shows that spots which are being present on the pupa, menage pupa, they are not ornamental. But from these gold spots, a special hormone is being secreted, which is responsible for the growth of the butterfly and which leads to full development of the pupa into a butterfly. Okay. So Dilpreet, yes. What was E. Bright studying? Okay, Raghav, what was E. Bright studying? Which hormone? He was actually studying about special insect hormone. Okay, so what was the belief, Madhav, about the insect hormone? What people think about this hormone? sorry, yes. Yes, so now, first thing is that what he was studying about the insect hormone, okay, right? Which insect hormone which were being secreted from the gold spots present in the Vanar's pupa. So what people believe about those gold spots? Yes. And even Ebright was also believing, yes, that these gold spots are only ornamental in nature, that they are only showing nature. They don't serve any specific purpose. But then what the observation they have come about, Kiti? Yes, that it secretes certain hormones which are necessary for the development of pupa into complete butterfly. It means that if this hormone would not be secreted, then what will happen? That the pupa will not develop into complete butterfly. Okay, so for this, what they have done? How they have come to know about the function of the insect hormone secreted by the gold spots? How they have come to know? They have made a special device. Ebright alone has made that special device? No. It was his another science student who was also very intelligent in studies. Along with him, he has made that device. So, this project was Ebright's first place in the county fair and entry into international science and engineering fair. So for this experiment, he has won first prize in county fair. And when he got first prize, then he has participated in the international engineering and science fair. This was his first, you can say, first door towards success when he has entered into the international stream of thinkers, right? So there he won third place for zoology. So when he has participated internationally or international science and engineering fair, so what happened? What he has got? He has got third place for zoology. So there are number of prizes. Don't get confused. Just remember that if a person will get first position only, then he will participate in the next competition. So remember that he has won first place in the county fair. This is the reason why he has participated in science and engineering fair. Right? And later on, what happened? What position he bagged in the international? Third position. And in which stream, which section? Zoology section. So he also got a chance to work during the summer at the entomology laboratory of the Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. What is entomology? Study of insects. It is. So, and after winning a prize there, he has also got a chance to work during the summers. During summer means he may be having vacations during that time. So summertime he can spend there at the entomology laboratory of the Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. See what kind of enjoyment he was having. So what usual people think, if we have holidays, just go hang out with your friends, go there, go here, enjoy, okay, right? And enjoy your life. And what he feels, it means if he is having vacation during summer, how he is spending? By getting a chance to work in the higher level of education. So just let us revise side by side, otherwise you will forget everything about the chapter. So what prize was won by Ebright in the international science and engineering fair? Third prize. In which stream he has got that prize? Zoology section. Okay. Which experiment he has shown there? Yes, which will develop into an adult butterfly. So what prize he has got, third prize, and along with what special opportunity he has got after participating. Yes, he has got a chance to work where? In the Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. So please underline it in your books. Underline, made a special circle. Have a highlighter with you. Highlight there. Now, as a high school junior, Richard E. Bright continued his advanced experiments on the monarch pupa. So what he did when he was high school junior student also, he was continuing his experiments, but not the simple experiments, but his advanced experiments. On what he is continuing his experiments on monarch pupa. That year, his project won first place at the International Science Fair and gave him another chance to work in the Army laboratory during the summer. So this time, when his project has been again participated, it was again displayed in the science fair, International Science Fair. There he got now first position, because earlier his experiments were of simple nature, but then he has learned new things. So then he has participated next year with his advanced experiments. And why participating in his advanced experiments? What prize he has won? First. And after that, again, what chance he has got? To work again in the laboratory during the summer. It is the same laboratory, that is Walter Reed Army Institute of Research. So it means that he has participated a number of times in the science fair. But every time he has learnt a new lesson. For the first time, he got third prize, and then afterwards he has got first prize. What he has got? He has got his first prize. So, in his senior year, he went a step further. Now from junior year, he has shifted to senior year. Then when a person will go from junior to the senior year, definitely there must be some kind of advancement. That is also shown in case of E. Bright. So Richard E. Bright continued his advanced experiment. He grew cells from a monarch wing in a culture and showed that cells would divide and develop into a normal butterfly wing scales only if they were fed the hormone from the gold spots. See, now what experiment he was doing, that he has taken some cells from the monarch wing. From the wing, he has taken that some cells and he has grown those cells in the culture. Then what inference he has come out with? That these cells, but first of all, these hormones, yes. If he is feeding those culture of cells with those, with the special hormone from the gold spots, only then that culture of cells, it is going to develop into complete butterfly wing, having scales, right? This is the next, his advancement in the senior year. So, and gave him another chance to work in the Army laboratory during the summer. So this is, I'm mixing the paragraphs. And will develop into wing scales only if they were fetched by the hormone from the gold spots. That project won first place for zoology at the international fair, and he spent the summer after graduation during further work at the Army Laboratory and at the laboratory of the US Department of Agriculture. So after winning the first prize, he has got various chances to participate in other, you can say, laboratories, in the to continue his work in other laboratories, for example. Which are the ones you can go? Yeah? No. Because her mother was not, yes, you please go. Yes. Her mother, his mother was not of that, you can say, a scientific temperament, although she had. But she could help him only during his young years. But tab to uski kya hai? Ebright has studied in higher level. He has vast knowledge of science. Her mother was supporting him in his experiments, like helping him out, providing him every facility that she can. But what role she is playing actively in his experiments, it is not mentioned anywhere. क्या? Yes, now he has got another partner along with his roommate, his college student. He was doing all these experiments. So see, it means that he was so focused towards his research work that for him, no or not any kind of distraction was there. He's participating in one science fair. So otherwise, what happened? If you participate in one competition, if the next one would come, he will say, no, ma'am, that's enough. Now I have got the prize. You yourself bring a full stop to your creativity. है ना? हमें होता है कि चलो ठीक है, this we have done, this we have won, now that's fine. Now I will focus upon this. But he had special interest in insects, right? He was studying that insect hormone, and after winning prize, he has won first prize in his junior high school. But after that, he did not stop there that I got first prize, now I should not participate. It means now you just remember that winning top position is still simple and easy, but maintaining that position is really very difficult, and he has to maintain that position. So the next year, in his senior year also, he has participated in that science fair. He wanted to go further. It means if he has won the previous year experiment or competition, it means he has set a benchmark for himself. He has set up a level for himself. It means that my next experiment would be higher, or it would be advanced than my previous one. Only then he would be able to get a prize, right? So this is how he was doing. He was setting benchmarks for himself. He was setting some levels for himself. Okay. So next time when he has participated, again he has got the prize, and finally he spent the summer after graduation during further work at Army Laboratory, where he was early working, and Laboratory of US Department of Agriculture. It means that he is getting number of opportunities, and he is always availing those opportunities. He is not making excuses that I have that study left, I have this thing left, I have that thing left, I have to carry forward that. No. He was focused towards his aim. So this is one of the things that the writer wants to deliver to us. Stay focused, be patient in order to hit the target, right? That's all for today. What we have learned till here, tomorrow we will continue further with the same chapter. Okay, there are number of, you can say, facts in this chapter that you have to remember, but ultimately the chapter is interesting one. Right? That's all for today now.